The singular value decomposition of a matrix A requires the singular values of A. But what are those values and how can we find them? That is what you will learn in this video. Let's start with a matrix A that is not square. So for example, A equals an M times N matrix. Well, then you can compute A transpose times A. That will be a symmetric matrix, and N times N symmetric matrix. So we have already learned a symmetric matrix has only real eigenvalues, so our n times n matrix will have n real eigenvalues. Moreover, as we'll show first, all those eigenvalues are positive, so they can be zero or bigger than zero. So we have a small proof for that. How can you see that? Well, we start with a normalized eigenvector v of A transpose times A, so the norm of v equals 1, and then we are going to compute the norm of AV squared. Why are we going to do that? Well, watch and see. The norm of AV squared is AV inner product with AV, by definition. Now, I have learned that if you have an inner product, for example, U inner product V, that you also can write this as a matrix product U transpose times V. So that's what we are going to do in this equality sign. We rewrite our inner product AV inner product AV as AV transpose times AV. And then you've learned that if you have the transpose of a product, that is the product of the transposes in the opposite order. So that's what we are going to do here. A times V transpose equals V transpose times A transpose. And there we have our A transpose times A times V. V was an eigenvector of A transpose times A. So A transpose A times V will give us lambda times v. And then we can put the lambda in front, so we have lambda times v transpose times v, and that's again v inner product v, so the norm of v squared. And we started with a normalized eigenvector, so this norm of v squared equals 1, so we end up with lambda. Then we have equality signs everywhere, so we have lambda equals norm of a times v squared, which is of course positive, so there we are. Now we've proven this small theorem, we are ready to see what singular values of a matrix A are. So what are those values? Well, first compute A transpose times A. That matrix will have n real eigenvalues. And then if you take the square root of those eigenvalues, you get the so-called singular values of A. So singular values sigma I of a matrix A are the square roots of the eigenvalues of A transpose times A. And then the convention is to put the largest one first. So you start with sigma 1, largest one, and next one, and so on, until the last one, smallest one. But the smallest one is still at least zero. And notice, here we have shown that lambda equals norm of AV squared, take square roots on both sides. Then you get sigma x the square root of lambda I equals the norm of A times V I. It's a useful equality which we will use later on. Now let's compute those singular values of some matrix A in an explicit case. Here we have our 3 by 2 matrix A. So this matrix A does not have normal eigenvalues, but we can still compute the singular values. First we compute A times A. And indeed, we get a symmetric matrix, 2 by 2 matrix. You know how to compute its eigenvalues. You compute the determinant of A minus lambda I and set it to 0. So compute the determinant, you get 2 minus lambda squared minus 1. So if you solve for that, you get lambda equals 2 plus or minus 1. So you get the eigenvalues lambda 1 equals 3 and lambda 2 equals 1. And then we have the singular values, the square roots of 3 and 1, so square root of 3 and 1, and as the convention dictates, we put sigma 1 equals square root of 3, largest one first, and then in this case the second one is also the smallest one, second, so our singular values are square root of 3 and 1.